This video is about whole genome sequencing. It explains the potential benefits and limitations for those who consider use of this technology. What is a genome? Your genome is all of the DNA in your body. DNA is a mixed sequence of four different chemical bases, A, C, G, and T. These bases are called deoxyribonucleic acids, or DNA. It is the order of these bases that gives you blue eyes or brown eyes and all other traits. Whole genome sequencing is the process of decoding all the information contained in your DNA. Every cell in your body contains the same DNA. That DNA is unique. Only you have that exact DNA unless you have an identical twin. That is why you are a unique individual. Half of your DNA was inherited from your mother and half from your father. That is why some of your physical traits are similar to those of your parents. This means that you typically have two copies of each gene, one from each of your parents. About 99% of all of your DNA is the same as the DNA in everyone else. The less than 1% difference that is dissimilar between each person is responsible for your uniqueness as an individual. This might not sound like much, but your entire DNA is approximately 3 billion bases long, which means there are actually millions of these bases that are different between you and every person on this planet. These unique bases are called variants. Scientists have found that variants in the DNA sequence can impact our health. For instance, the DNA sequence in a person with Huntington's disease is different from the DNA sequence in a healthy person. In other diseases, like heart disease, type 2 diabetes, or cancer, for example, many different variants play a role in disease development to varying degrees. For example, mutations in BRCA genes are known to significantly increase the risk of ovarian and breast cancers. The development of such diseases is complex and can also involve environmental factors as well as lifestyle choices. Inherited disorders like Huntington's disease will develop irrespective of environment and lifestyle choices because the genetic variance acquired from the parents is all that is needed to lead to a disease. Genome sequencing allows scientists to observe what variants are present in your DNA sequence and compare it with past accumulated information. In this way, scientists can determine the risk that you might develop a specific disease. This risk can range from small, as is often the case for diseases such as heart disease, which has many different influencing factors, to 100% risk, as is observed with some inherited diseases. If your DNA contains variants that have unwanted consequences to your health, whole genome sequencing may be able to identify the variant and help you and your doctor to direct you towards the right prevention, monitoring, or treatment if it is available. Whole genome sequencing can also reveal whether prospective parents could be carriers of variants that could lead to disease. Such parents can be completely healthy, but if both parents carry the same mutation, the child that inherits these variants from each parent will develop the disease. Sickle cell anemia is one such example. Therefore, whole genome sequencing can help in reproductive decisions, especially for individuals with a family history of a certain disease. Another advantage of whole genome sequencing is the information it can provide about the use of medication. Just as the variants you possess can be informative about the risk of disease development, variants can also provide clues as to whether a certain medication may or may not be effective for you, or whether it could produce unwanted side effects. In whole genome sequencing, millions of additional variants are identified, many pointing to personal traits or ancestry origins, or traits with indirect medical impact, such as a predisposition to obesity. For many variants, the significance is still unknown to science. However, understanding of variant consequences grows as more people have their genome sequenced. Now about the limitations of whole genome sequencing. First, complete accuracy of a sequenced genome cannot be guaranteed, although it is so high that genome sequencing is now certified for clinical use. Second, some sections of the human genome contain regions of unusually structured sequence that can be difficult to decipher. Therefore, an entire genome cannot actually be sequenced. However, this represents only a minor fraction of the genome, and technologies now exist that can overcome these obstacles. Finally, it needs to be understood that an obtained DNA sequence can provide varying degrees of information, including no useful information, or information that might not be desirable and might lead to emotional distress. For example, discovering that one could develop a disease for which there is no cure, such as Alzheimer's disease, would be an unpleasant shock, to say the least. In addition, the data obtained from your genome sequence reveals information that could be influential to family members. Their well-being and opinion should also be considered prior to deciding to sequence your genome. How much of the information you desire to obtain from your sequence and with whom you choose to share it will depend on you. We hope this video has helped you to understand whole genome sequencing and the factors you should consider before having your genome sequenced.